Hello viewers, so I'm back again with the fourth video in the playlist Solution to American Code Civil Engineering Quiz Series for September 2020 on my YouTube channel MSG Engineering. This fourth video covers solutions to quiz from 19th to 24th September 2020. So under MSG Engineering Academy and Consultancy, I conducted a civil engineering quiz in September 2020. One multiple choice question on American codes was asked per day from 1st to 30th September, and many civil engineers participated in the quiz across the globe. The winners list is in the first solution video. This is the fourth solution video. As I said, the quiz series is conducted to increase the awareness about the different country codes. Hope someone finds it useful. Do subscribe to my channel, like, share videos with your friends and colleagues. Do join my online civil engineering courses. So, starting with the quiz solution, day 19. It was Saturday, 19 September 2020, and the question was, which American Concrete Institute's publication is used for purpose similar to the Indian Code publication SP34? Choose the correct alternative. Four options were given, and C, ACI 315 was the correct option. So ACI 315 in American Code is very similar to what is published in SP34 of Bureau of Indian Standards. So the correct answer is C, ACI 315. And for explanation, refer below the cover page ACI 315 R 2018 Guide to Presenting Reinforcing Steel Design Details. Similar to the Indian Code publication SP34, it is Bureau of Indian Standard publication, Handbook on Concrete Reinforcement and Detailing. Cover page is attached for reference. So the correct bending position of reinforcement bars and preparation of bar bending schedule in various structural members is explained in both of them. So ACI 315 in American codes is very similar to or running parallel to SP34 in Indian codes. And on the next page, I have attached a cover page of ACI 315R 2018 Guide to Presenting Reinforcing Steel Design Details. And also there is a cover page of Handbook on Concrete Reinforcement and Detailing by Bureau of Indian Standards. It is SP34. So this was the 19th question. Next, going to day 20, Sunday, the 20th September 2020. And the question was, which American Concrete Institute's publication serves the purpose similar to the Indian Code publication SP16? Four alternatives were given, and the correct alternative was SP17, 2014. So the correct answer was SP17 2014. Refer below the cover page of explanatory handbooks SP17 2014, the reinforced concrete design handbook, and Bureau of Indian Standard publication SP16 for design aids. So this is SP17 volume 1, the Reinforced Concrete Design Handbook. They call it the companion to ACI 318. So ACI 318 is a RCC design code of USA. It's American RCC code. And to solve the various problems using ACI 318, we refer to SP17. SP17 contains the design aid charts and tables and shortcut methods which can be used for designing as per ACI 318. Very similar to that, in India, We have design aids for reinforced concrete IS 456, and this is called SP16 design aids to reinforce concrete. So this also has various charts and tables to quickly design the RCC structures, various elements of RCC structures. So next I am going to question number 21 on day 21, Monday 21st September 2020, and the question was, what is the maximum grade of high strength reinforcement per the latest American code ACI 318? Choose the correct alternatives. The alternatives were grade 60, B grade 80, C was grade 100, D was grade 115. So ACI 318 is the American RCC code, RCC design code, and the latest version is 2019, and the high strength reinforcement grades are these are in inch pound system, FPS system code, and the correct answer is C, grade 100, that is grade 100, or that is FY 100 PSI, PSI is pounds per square inch. Refer below for explanation. Refer below the cover page of ACI 318-19 in inch pound units. This is that cover page, ACI 318-19. It is in inch pound system, and this is a building code for RCC in America. Also, I have attached on it a small table, 20.2.2.4B. Chapter 20 in RCC code is for reinforcement. So this chapter 20, table 20.2.2.4A and B, I have attached over here. And this table A is for non-prestressed deformed bars, and it shows that maximum grade is having FY 100 PSI. So this is 100 PSI, that is the maximum grade used. For non-prestressed plain spiral reinforcement also, maximum grade used is 100 PSI. The commentary on this chapter 20 says that unless special containment reinforcement is provided to increase the limiting concrete compressive strain, the maximum value of yield strength for calculation purposes is limited to 100 PSI. So maximum grade of reinforcement used in American code is having 100 PSI, pounds per square inch, or grade 100. Okay, so this is answer to the 21st day question. Now going to day 22, Tuesday 22nd September 2020, and the question is, what is AST minimum or non-prestress one-way slab with deformed bars reinforcement of grade less than 60 KSI per the latest ACI 318. So what is the minimum percentage reinforcement for one-way slabs having reinforcement grade less than 60 KSI, that is mild steel, that is tar steel, that is very similar to our Fe 415. So, according to ACI 318 latest, that is 2019 version, what is the minimum percentage reinforcement in one-way slab? And the four options were given, and the correct option is D, 0.0018 into AG, that is 0.18% of gross cross-sectional area of one-way slab. And the explanation and reference to it I have attached on the next page. I have attached a cover page of ACI 318 2019. This is in SI system, SI units. I have also attached, now chapter number 7 is for one-way slabs, and in chapter 7 for one-way slabs, clause number 7.6 is about reinforcement limits. And 7.6.1.1 says that minimum flexural reinforcement in non-prestressed slabs, minimum area of percentage reinforcement, AS minimum is 0.0018 into AG. So AG is the gross cross-sectional area, that is thickness of a slab ओवरऑल थिकनेस ऑफ अ स्लैब कैपिटल डी इंटू यूनिट विड्थ ऑफ अ स्लैब से 1000 mm. सो 0.18% इज द मिनिमम परसेंटेज रिएनफोर्समेंट. इट इज़ डिफरेंट दैन अवर आईएस कोड. वॉट डज आईएस कोड स्पेसिफाई? मिनिमम परसेंटेज रिएनफोर्समेंट इन स्लैब्स. इफ यू डोंट नो इट, डू कॉन्टैक्ट मी. आई डू टेक courses in the design and detailing of RCC and steel structures. So do contact me if you don't know what is the minimum percentage in slabs in IS codes. Next, going to the day 23 question, Wednesday 23rd September, which is the publication of ACI for the foundations base and bases to support equipment and machinery. Choose correct alternative: ACI 318, ACI 351, PIP and API. So of all these four alternatives, alternative B, ACI 351, is the correct alternative. ACI stands for American Concrete Institute, and 351 code is for foundations and bases to support equipments and machinery. ACI 351, it covers both the dynamic loads machinery foundation and static machinery foundation also. This is the code as in ACI or American Concrete Institute. The first alternative, ACI 318, is the general building code in RCC, in American code. PIP is process industry practices standards. Yes, PIP also has standards for foundation of the plant equipments. But the question was ACI publication for foundation to plant equipment. So ACI 351 is the correct answer. API is American Petroleum Institute. They also have standards, but ACI standard for this is ACI 351. And to explain that correct answer B is ACI 351, I have attached a cover page of ACI 351 to R94 foundation for static equipment. That is this ACI 351 2R94. This is for static equipment. Static equipments are the stationary equipments. This, they are standstill. The examples are vertical vessel, horizontal vessel, heat exchanger, cylindrical storage tanks, mounted bullets, spherical vessels, even the transformers. All these are static equipments. To know more about the design steps, design of static equipment foundations, do contact me. I conduct online courses on that. And the second attachment is ACI 351 3R-4. It is foundation of dynamic equipments. So dynamic equipments, if you want to learn, examples of dynamic equipments is pumps, blowers, turbines, DG diesel generator, compressors. So all these are dynamic equipments. That means they are not static. That means they are either vibrating, rotating, or having impact hammer type of action. So for that, this code is used. Again, PIP, there are many standards, API, PIP standards, and some textbooks are also followed for this. So if you want to learn the foundation to dynamic equipments, do contact me, do join my academy for learning this. I conduct online courses on this. Now the last question, day 24, Thursday 24th September 2020, in the video number 4, the question is, as per AC7, what is the minimum fluid specific weight density gamma soil for determining tsunami hydrostatic loads accounting for suspended solids and debris flow embedded smaller objects? So the correct alternative is 64 pound per square cubic feet, 70.4 pounds per cubic feet, or 2 SL per cubic feet and 2.2 SL per cubic feet. So the correct answer is B, 70.4. And for that, for supporting the answer, I have given the cover page of AC 7 2016 and the chapter 6 in AC7. AC7 is the loading code of America, and in that chapter 6 is for tsunami loads. It's a new chapter added in 2019, and in that clause number 6.8.4 says that minimum fluid density for tsunami loads, gamma soil, gamma S, for determining tsunami hydrostatic loads accounting for suspended solids and debris flow embedded similar objects is 70.4 pounds per cubic feet. And to support that, I have attached a cover page of AC7 2016 is the latest version. This is the loading code of America. I have also attached one paragraph from chapter 6. Chapter 6 is for tsunami loads, and clause number 6.8.4 says minimum fluid density for tsunami loads. And they have said that the specific seawater specific weight density is 64 pound per cubic feet, and for tsunami loads, the tsunami hydrostatic loads, the suspended solid and debris flow density is Ks times the seawater intensity. Seawater is 64, I told you just now, 64 pounds per cubic feet into Ks. Ks is 1.1. So 1.1 into 64 will be the tsunami water density, and 1.1 into 64 is 70.4 pound per cubic feet. So that is the correct answer. So for finding the forces or loads or hydrostatic forces because of tsunami water, what density you have to take? You don't have to take a clean water density, but you have to take 70.4 pounds per cubic feet, because that is the density including debris. So this completes the 6 answers from day 19 to day 24. So this is my 4th video. Do like my videos, do subscribe to my channel, share with your friends and colleagues, join my MHG Engineering Academy online courses for designing and detailing of especially industrial structures, RCC and steel structures. I do take courses in American, Euro and Indian code. So do join my academy, and bye bye for now.